Everyone, it's Insko here. Welcome back to another video. Yesterday, Don Diablo released his new album, Forever, which is his second album. I feel like I've been waiting for a Don Diablo album for years now. I haven't listened to the album. I know there's about 10 or 11 songs on the album that were previously released as singles. But today I'm going to be listening to the album from start to finish, all the way through, and giving my opinions and also rating all of the songs out of 10. And yeah, I'm honestly really excited. I don't know what to expect. I just hope it's good. The first song is called Forever, and it's with Don Diablo and Camp Kubrick, which I think Camp Kubrick is Don Diablo and someone else, but they do kind of like 80s styled stuff. So I'm expecting that from this song, but I don't know. Sounds like some sort of room recording. See, this already makes me feel like I'm gonna go for a journey listening to this album. Okay, so far, good intro to the album. Doesn't feel like it's meant to be a proper song, but more of like a introduction, which is, I guess, what it is. Or do we have a drop? Okay. Yeah, it's very Camp Kubrick, which is what I expected. Can't say I really listen to that kind of thing, because it isn't really my kind of thing, but still a cool intro to the album nonetheless. Yeah, this is cool. I don't really know what to say about it. It's just a nice intro track. So that one is a pretty good intro track. Don't really think it's my kind of thing though. I'm probably going to rate it like a 5 out of 10 on just overall song. Just because I rated it low though, doesn't mean that I don't have high expectations for this album, because I do. But moving on to track number 2, it's with Don Diablo and Freak Fantastique. Okay, I've never heard of Freak Fantastique before, so interesting. Ooh. Oh, I like this song. That's good vibes to it. I'm so excited for this album. I'm so happy to be listening to this. Oh, I do really like this song. I like this. I actually really like this. Nice. Yep. I'm a fan of this one. I don't know what it was about it that I like so much. It just had good vibes, and the vocal stacks and everything sounded really nice. I think I'm going to rate that like a 9 out of 10. I was going to say so far it's my favorite song, but I've only listened to 2 songs, so that don't really mean a lot. But that is, yeah, that's, I do really like that song. This next one is Sail Away by Don Diablo and Aura. Different, interesting synth. Okay. It's not as energetic as I expected. It's pretty chill, but I do quite like it. Obviously, Aura has a nice voice. I've heard her voice in collaborations with other producers. I do really like this hook. It's chill. It's just chill. So far, I'm impressed with the album, but I'm only 3 songs in. Is it really a Don Diablo song if there isn't a vocoder? It's nice. I think because I really like the hook of the song, that's one of the main reasons I like it. But then the chill bit is kind of like I expected something a bit more upbeat, but I do also like it. So I think if I listen to it a few times, I'll probably like it more. I'm going to rate that one a 7 out of 10 for now. But like I said, if I listen to it more, I'll probably like it more. This next one is the first one on the album that was already released as a single before, and I actually made a video of me reacting to this song. But as we're listening to the album, how it's meant to be listened to, I'm still going to listen to it all anyway. If you do want to watch me react to this song for the first time though, there'd be like a card at the top of the screen, or I'll put the link in the description. But this is Tears for Later with Don Diablo and Galantis. This song's definitely grown on me more since I first listened to it. So weird, but so cool. It's just interesting. All of like the effects and just everything about this song is just weird, but nice. And especially the bass as well. It's a good song. I do really like that song. I also completely forgot to put on my glasses, so now they're on. Anyway, I think I'm going to rate that one a 8 out of 10. The fifth song on the album is called Good Time, and it's just with Don Diablo and no one else. This one wasn't released before, so it's a brand new song. Let's go. Oh, I don't know whether I'm going to like this one. It's got 80s vibes. I don't hate 80s vibes. I just don't love it. Okay. Okay. Let's see where this goes. I'm intrigued. I tell you what, that's actually nice. I thought it was going to be 80s vibes. No. I can't lie, I don't know whether I'm a fan of the vocal though. This bit's cool. It's just the other vocal, I'm kind of like, eh. Oh, nice vocal chops. Nice. Nice kind of bridge section. I can't speak. Yeah, nice. Okay, this is good. This is good. If that main vocal wasn't there, I think I would like it more. I don't know what it is that I don't like about it. I don't know whether it's just the fact that I don't like their voice or the way it's processed or what. It just, I don't know. I just don't really like it. The rest of the song with like the vocal stacks and the drops sounded great. I think because of the vocal though, I'm going to have to rate it like a 6 out of 10. I do think it could grow on me though, but that's just how I feel at the moment. Song number 6 is another new song and it's called Make a Change with Don Diablo and Kong. You gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta say okay. What you need to say. Like this voice more already. This is gonna be a feel good song. I know it. Okay. Give me a good drop. Ooh. This is like so reminding me of his other album. I remember listening to his other album on my phone at like midnight with school the next day. It just makes me so happy to be listening to another Don Diablo album. I really like this actually. This is a good song. Nice like switch up. That was a really good song. I think that one is gonna be a 9 out of 10. It's about in line as Stay Awake for me. Has a good message, good vibe, fairly minimalistic drop, but it works really well. Number 7 is a track that was released before. It's called Too Much to Ask with Don Diablo and Ty Dolla Sign. I haven't listened to this song in a while, but from what I can remember, I think I did like this quite a lot. It is a good song. I can't even remember when it was released. I feel like it's quite a while ago now, though. It's one of the more kind of poppy ones, but I like it. It's good. Not my favorite drop ever, but yeah, like I keep saying, it's good. I like the rhythm in the verse as well. It's chill. Yeah, I mean, overall, great song. Definitely isn't my favorite, though, but it was in my playlist for quite a long time. I think I'm probably going to rate that like a 7 out of 10. Track number 8 is another single that was released before, but I think this one was even earlier than the Ty Dolla Sign one. This one's called Survive, and it's with Don Diablo, Emily Sande, and Gucci Mane. Now, from what I remember, I wasn't very keen on this song. But I haven't listened to it in probably like a year or however long it's been. So we're going to give it a listen and we're going to see if my opinion's changed. This is cool. I like this bit. I don't think I'm a massive fan of Gucci Mane's voice. I'm not going to lie. It just seems strange on this kind of song. I still don't really like it. Like, this bit's okay. It's just like, I don't know what it is. I can't even explain what it is that I don't like about it. I don't think I'm a fan of Gucci Mane's voice and just the vibe in general. I mean, this song has 48 million views, so I'm clearly going to be upsetting some people by saying this. Yeah, it's just, it's okay. I've listened to Don Diablo since like 2013, 2014, something like that. And I think that is probably my least favorite song by him. I don't know why I don't like it so much. I just don't. I think I'm going to rate that like a 4 out of 10. So I was just looking to see when that song actually came out, just out of curiosity. 2018. So it was more than a year ago the last time I heard it. It was like 3 years ago. Anyway, track number 9 is Hot Air Balloon by Don Diablo and Arco. This one was released last week, I think, or 2 weeks ago. I've done a reaction video on this as well. So if you want to check that out, I'll leave a card. I've done a reaction to that the first time I listened to that anyway. So if you want to check that out, I'll leave a card or the link in the description. I am a fan of this one, though. It's still in my playlist. I still enjoy it. I will say this, though. Even though I didn't like that Survive song, this album's been pretty versatile so far. It's just good vibes. Isn't too much. It's pretty chill. I like it. And the little filter effect as well. It's nice. Yeah, I'm a big fan of this song. I like how the whole song is kind of based on that guitar sample. But it just works really well. I'm going to rate that one an 8 out of 10. I like it. It's groovy. It's chill. Right, track number 10. We're about halfway through because there's like 21 tracks on the album. This one's a new one and it's called From the Deep by Don Diablo and Enigma. Okay. Don't know how I feel about this just yet. Right. I don't know what to think. I may be smiling, but I don't know if I like it or not yet. Aww. I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know if I'm a fan of that, like, glitchy kind of art lead thing. Yeah, I don't know. It might grow on me, maybe, but as of now, not really a fan, to be honest. I mean, it's got a lot of interesting stuff in it, of course, but yeah, I don't know. Just isn't my favorite. Yeah, I think honestly, just not really a fan of that one. I'm going to rate that one a 5 out of 10 just because it's slap bang in the middle and I'm not saying it's good or bad. It's just okay. I mean, I'm going to listen to the whole album a few more times anyway, so it might grow on me. Track number 11 is another new one. It's called Invisible and it's just by Don Diablo. No features. Okay. Like the vibe. I like this so far. The vibe is really nice. Come on, please be a good drop. Because I actually really like this so far. Okay. Interesting. The bass is like Slap House, and I don't like Slap House, but it's interesting. The vocal's nice and the vibe's nice. I think this one's gonna grow on me. I mean, I already quite like it. I don't know how I feel about the drop. I like that. Yeah, I don't know. It's cool. It is cool. Feels like it's just not quite hitting it for me. That's a weird one, that. I liked it up until the drop. And then the drop was kind of like, I don't know. It was okay. But like I said, I do think it's going to grow on me. I think I'm probably going to rate that like a 7 out of 10. Track number 12 is another new song and it's called Beautiful Feeling. And it's also just by Don Diablo. Okay. Weird synth. But I'm intrigued. Don't know how I feel about the vocal, it's just alright. Oh, I like the hook. Okay, not bad. Not bad. I like it. Just don't think it's one of my favorites. I think at the moment, Stay Awake is still my favorite song on the album. That bass, I don't think I'm a fan of though. It's a bit weird. Yeah, I already like the drop more. Now I'm hearing it again. So again, I think it's going to be one of the ones that grows on me. Which it seems like all of these songs are going to grow on me. Nice outro. Weird, but nice. I'm probably going to rate that a 7 out of 10. I can't remember how many 7 out of 10s I've done, but it feels like a lot. It's decent. I like the hook. I think the bass was a little bit weird. The drop was a bit strange, but I'm starting to like it more. Track 13 is called Bad. It's with Don Diablo and Zaka Bell. This one, I think, also was released quite a long time ago. It's also just clicked with me that I'm pretty sure it was meant to release an album like a year or two ago. So in a way, it kind of makes sense for these older songs to be on the album. Maybe he just like doubled the track list or something and still kept the old songs. From what I remember, I like this song, but to be completely honest, I can't even remember how it goes. Now I remember how it goes. Okay, yeah, I do like this song. Yeah, good song. Again, a super weird drop, but it's nice. Yeah, this is a really good song. I really like this song. I'm going to rate that one a 9 out of 10 as well, just because that is one of my favorite songs. I really like it. I don't think I was keen on it really when it came out, but it grew on me, like I hope the rest of the songs on this album are going to. Track 14 is also one that was released before. It's called Problems, and it's by Don Diablo, JLV, and John K. Again, I can't remember this song, but I'm pretty sure I like this as well. Yeah, I do know this song. I really like this song. This is actually one of my favorite Don Diablo songs. It's such a feel-good song. Love it. So good. It's weird, but it's nice. Banger. I love it. Such a good song. Yeah, I think overall that just is a really good song, and it's one of my favorite Don Diablo songs. I'm actually gonna rate that a 10 out of 10. That is the first song on this album that's a 10 out of 10 for me. I don't know what it is about it. I just think it's a really good vibe song, and I really like it. Track 15 is called High Low, and it's just by Don Diablo and no one else. Brand new track as well, so I haven't heard this one. Okay. Oh, okay, that's quicker than what I thought it was going to be. Wait, this has got like a... almost like a drum and bass beat pattern. Are we getting a different genre of music in this album? He had a drum and bass track on the first album, so I wouldn't be surprised. It could also be like an 80s style, though. I don't know. Not bad so far. Right. Interesting. So I want those drums to hit harder. I want it to be a little bit more kind of aggressive, have a bit more oomph behind it. But instead, it's kind of more like a 80s style thing, which just isn't really my thing. I like this bit. This bit's nice. I mean, it's cool, but it's just like, I want more. It's just, yeah, it's okay. I'm gonna rate that like a 4 out of 10 because it just wasn't for me. Like I said, I wanted those drums to hit a bit harder. That could have been a really nice drum and bass track, but instead he kind of just went down the 80s route, and it just, yeah, ain't really for me. Track 16 is another single that was released before, and it's called Kill Me Better with Don Diablo, Iman Beck, and Trevor Daniel. I do remember this song, and I don't think I really liked it. I liked the vocals on it a lot, but the direction that Don Diablo took it, again, just wasn't really my thing. But either way, we're gonna give it a listen and we're gonna see if my opinion's changed. I just wanna feel alright. Like, the vocal is nice. Really, it almost reminds me of like Juice WRLD or something. And then it's this like 80s vibe thing that I'm just like, ah. It's not for me, it just isn't my style of music. I mean, don't get me wrong, he does this style of music really well. Like, it sounds great, it just isn't for me. Like, this song almost feels like a remix to me. I don't know why. Again, I'd probably rate that like a 4 out of 10 just because it isn't my style of music. Track 17 is another single that was released before. It's called Into the Unknown and it's just by Don Diablo. I'm not actually recognizing it. Oh, now I know it, yeah. I like this song. Yeah, it's a nice song. Very minimalistic again, but it's nice. Yeah, I do really like this song. Again, I feel like this song kind of adds that versatility to the album. Especially how it changes up here. Just weird and really minimalistic, like I said, but I really like it. Gonna rate that one an 8 out of 10. It's fairly minimalistic, but it's different, and I really liked it when it came out. Track 18 is another single that was released before. It's called Through the Storm and it's by Don Diablo and Jordan McCamper. I remember this song. It's kind of upsetting because it's like this one and Into the Unknown. If I didn't know the songs before, I'd probably be freaking out over these songs because they're good songs. Yeah, it is just a good song. Yeah, I really like this song. Yeah, it's a good song. It is one of my favorite songs. I'm going to rate that an 8 out of 10. I think I also rated Into the Unknown an 8 out of 10. This one is another single that came out before. It's called A Thousand Faces and it's by Don Diablo and Andy Grammer. I don't think I can remember this one either. I think it's a few years old, but let's give it a listen. Wait, was this not on his album? His last one? It feels like that long ago. But this is a good song. I tried twice as hard to be half the man you made me. There's a thousand faces. Yeah, this song's really good. I think this was the one that was about his dad, because his dad passed away. There's a thousand voices. Yeah, this is a really good song. I do really like this. Really nice. Yeah, I really like this song. I really do. It's definitely one of my favorites again. Just such a clean song and has such a nice message as well. I'm going to rate that one a 10 out of 10 because the message is really nice and the vibe of the song is really nice. I've skipped track number 20 as it was literally a minute long and it was just an interlude. Didn't really do or say anything. It was just kind of like an ambience. But we are on the last track of the album, which is called Race, Welcome to Hexagonia. It's just by Don Diablo. I don't know whether this is also going to be some sort of like soundscape thing or whether it's going to be an actual song. It's 3 minutes long though, so I am expecting it to be a song, but we'll see. Okay. Well, that got dramatic. Right. I think it's more like a soundtrack kind of thing. Right. I don't really know how to react to this kind of thing. Movie trailer vibes. Okay. Is there actually going to be a drop or something? Is this going to switch up? I think there is. Oh. Okay. I don't know whether it's my kind of thing, though, to be honest, but it's pretty heavy. I mean, I wasn't expecting that. It makes sense why the song is called Race Now, because it's saying push the gas pedal and then it's like car sounds. But other than the drop, it just feels really dramatic and movie trailer-like. This is really different, though. Again, this is adding that versatility to the album. Nice. Yeah, it's really nicely done. And that's it. Okay, you know what? Pretty good album. Before I make my overall comments on the album, I'm going to rate that last song before I forget. I'm going to rate it like a 7 out of 10. It isn't necessarily my kind of music, but it was really interesting. At first, I thought it was just going to be some cinematic thing because it was pretty dramatic. But it did turn into like a pretty heavy song, and it's nice to see that switch up. So what are my final thoughts of the album Forever by Don Diablo? If I'm being honest, I think I expected a little bit more. There were some songs on there that surprised me and ones that I really liked. And then there was others that were kind of okay, but I felt like they would grow on me. Whereas his last album, I loved every single song on that album. I was smiling the whole time. I think the best way for me to express my opinions on this album is just to say that the songs that were already released that are probably the best songs on the album, especially towards the end of the album where you got Into the Unknown, Through the Storm and A Thousand Faces. If those songs didn't already release as singles, I would have absolutely loved those songs. But because I've already heard them and they were released a few years ago, it was just kind of like, oh, okay, it's just that song again. I just think for the majority of the songs, I prefer the old Don Diablo than the new Don Diablo, especially with that 80s style music. He's got some interesting sound design and just interesting elements to his songs in general. So in a way, I'm thankful that the older stuff is featured on the album because it gives me more of a reason to want to listen to it. But at the same time, I would have loved some newer songs that are in the same kind of style as those older songs. So overall, I'm going to rate the album a 7 out of 10. I feel like I've rated so many songs on the album a 7 out of 10, so it only feels right to rate it a 7 out of 10. Still going to be listening to the album. I'm going to be giving all of the songs another chance as well, because sometimes it does take a while for me to like a song. But that's my reaction and my review of Don Diablo's new album, Forever. This video took me forever to film. See what I did there? So if you do enjoy it, please hit the like button. Also, subscribe and turn on notifications if you haven't already and you do enjoy this kind of content. But my name is Insko, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.